There's a look at one of the most iconic sports venues in the lower 48, built back in 1957 under the title of City Stadium. We are at Lambeau Field in Green Bay, Wisconsin. Happy to be on hand. I'm Brandon Gaudin with Charles Davis. And before we kick, partner, your keys to the game, please.
Well, my keys are on the defensive side of the ball for both teams. And the big one, making sure you avoid giving up the big play. These safeties are going to get tested all game long. Their job, keep the ball in front of them, tackle people, make them run extra plays in order to try and score.
Two men ready to do battle. It's time to dance. And off we go from Lambeau. And he takes this near the 25. Just a little pass there. Call it the 26. The Cardinals offense heading out, and they do so behind Kyler Murray, their dynamic quarterback in his sixth season now from Oklahoma.
And now that he's back at full health, they're expecting Kyler to get back to being the superstar playmaker that they drafted. Make no mistake about it, when he's fully healthy, there aren't many quarterbacks who are as dynamic as he is. And if he's able to stay on the field, this team has a real chance to make some noise.
They'll start out here with the option left. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. The game's first play produces 6 yards, brings up second down. A little do-it-yourself run right there, and a nice gain.
Now, I like that he knew that that was about all he was going to get, so he did a nice job of protecting himself, took care of the football, took what the defense gave him. If they continue to allow him to do that, they'll find their way taking what they can all the way to the end zone.
And Connor going to pick up a Cardinals first down as he'll be brought down at the 38-yard line.
Connor picks up a new set of downs and in nice fashion, too. He's coming off his best season as a pro after he topped the 1,000-yard mark for the first time in his career a season ago.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Again, a run with Connor. And this winds up a gain of 4 to the 41.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. He wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
From the 41, here's second and 6. To throw is Murray. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. No one there to help out downfield, but no problem. Scrambling for 22 and a first.
Well, that turned out better than most of the passes he could have thrown on that snap. The coverage downfield was excellent, but the containment close to home left him a backdoor escape, and they paid dearly for not locking up.
So into Packer territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 37-yard line. Murray now to throw. Got his man. It's Dortch. A good gain of 9 before he's brought down at the 28.
And I think this is a route we'll see more of as this game goes on, because with his speed, they want to get him the ball in space on drag routes just like this. They want him to get the ball and run after the catch. Good job there, though, holding him for a short gain.
Now Murray. And he's going to be taken down back around the 35-yard line. Quay Walker came through to make the sack. And this is a quarterback who's already had success on the ground in this first half, but this time they're able to hem him in.
And it's always different when you rush a mobile quarterback as opposed to a guy you know will be right back in the pocket. In this case, you got to make sure the inside pressure and the outside pressure match, and maybe even a second wave to make sure if he squirts free, you've got someone to tackle him.
Here comes the 7th play of this opening drive. They've moved it well, but here's 3rd down. There's Murray. Pass to the sideline and pulled in. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. It's a gain of 11 and a Cardinal first down. Solid opening drive so far, Charles. They've moved this football into field goal range, but you know that they want to cap this off with six and not three.
Absolutely. As one of the better coaches in the league always tells me, on offense, I want their body blows all game long and finish it with uppercuts. Well, here are the body blows right now. He's hoping one uppercut will take care of the end of this drive.
That'll go for a gain of 7, and that'll bring up second down.
In so many ways, throwing the hitch route is actually one of the safer things an offense can do. Get the ball out to the receiver as fast as possible, hope he's got man-to-man coverage, and hope that his athleticism wins on the perimeter.
Here's Murray. And to the left side here, Wilson. That good for 6 as they keep this drive right on rolling. Really a solid start here on the opening drive, Charles. He's now 4-4, and they're already in plus territory.
Brandon, he's been so precise to start this game, like we're watching an operation taking place right now. Master surgeon at work.
Shotgun now for Murray. Over the middle, it's complete. Call it a gain of 3 on the play, and it'll be second down. And forget about the run to set up the pass. They're just coming out throwing.
Forget trying to set anything up. They feel like they have the advantage. They feel like they have the matchups, and they're just attacking right now.
Yep, going to the air on the opening drive. The ball on the 8 still could get a first down technically. Second and 7 from the gun, Murray. That's to McBride, and he has it. Touchdown, Cardinals. 8 yards on the touchdown pass, and the Cardinals have taken the early lead on the road here at Lambeau. Such an art to dot the I, just get the feet in right there against the line before going out of bounds.
Such an incredibly graceful, athletic play, but also a lot of practice goes into it. They work on that to make sure that they learn how to train their feet to get.
And we remember, of course, all scoring plays need to be verified upstairs, and I think they're going to at least take a look at this. They're taking a peek at whether or not those feet were in bounds, and obviously a big call here in the end zone.
And not just the feet. How about the hands? How is the ball possessed while the feet are hopefully getting down in bounds? That's what they're trying to look at to see if it all comes together.
So they called it a touchdown originally, and this will stay a touchdown after the video review, so they had it right. Now Matt Prater for the point after. And the Cardinals will go up 7-0. So that one a long 11-play drive. And it was capped off by a touchdown reception from Trey McBride. After the touchdown, out is Prater to kick. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. So the Packers make their way out for the first time, and it's Jordan Love that has the keys to the car here in his 5th season as a pro and 2nd as a starter.
And Love established himself as a legitimate franchise quarterback a season ago. And let's not forget, he had to exhibit a lot of patience waiting for his opportunity to become the man. And once he got that chance, he hit the ground running. The question now from the rest of the league, can he sustain that success? The Packers certainly believe he will.
On play action, Love to throw. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. That one will set him back nearly 10 yards here on first down of the sack.
Okay, partner, a couple points of interest right here, all right? Offensively, we see that they came out throwing the football, but maybe more importantly, the blitz that came defensively, they got right after
it. And you were telling me pregame, before we came on air, you think this is something we could see a lot.
Yeah, there's no doubt about it, because this is a unit that wants to play the game on their terms.
After the sack, it's 2nd and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here. First rep of the game for Josh Jacobs. And that didn't fool anybody. He's going to be dropped in the backfield. It'll be a loss of a full 3 yards there, and it also brings up third down.
When a draw works, it can be a thing of beauty. But when it doesn't, oh, it can be ugly. And in this case, loss of yardage ugly.
Now third down and very long. Love now. The throw here right sideline falls incomplete.
That was their first third down try of the game, and clearly something was off in the execution of that play. Good news, they've got a whole game left to clean that up and start clicking on those key third down throws.
On fourth down, the Packers call on Daniel Whelan to punt. And back deep is DJ Dallas. Yards on the punt, give him just 1 yard on the return, and the Cards will take over first and 10. So the Cardinals offense back onto the field here for their second drive of the game. They'll be looking to duplicate that first drive, the one that got them that 7-0 lead.
Of course they would. I mean, look, they're on the road, so getting the 7-0 lead was huge for them, right? Imagine getting up 2 touchdowns on the road, taking the crowd out of the game. It'd be ideal.
They start with a give to Connor, and the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
Two things to watch. First is strength and being able to break out of that initial contact. But at his size, once you slow his momentum, it's hard for him to get it started again and end up tackling him behind the line of scrimmage.
Now Murray off play action. Blitz coming and down he goes. Eric Wilson from his outside linebacker spot, forcing the sack for a loss of 8.
And this is what you've got to do against a quarterback like him. You've got to keep him in the pocket and not let him get to the perimeter, because once he gets outside, that's where he can really hurt you.
Well, that last sack puts Murray and the Cards in a tough spot, third and long. He'll drop to throw. And that is incomplete.
As a defensive back, you have some weapons at your disposal that we don't often talk about, and you can read the receiver's eyes, you can read his hands, and you know that the arrival of the ball is imminent, and that allows you to make a play on it and oftentimes knock it away.
Blake Gillikin on to punt now on fourth down. And the fair catch is taken at about the 13-yard line here. So possession goes over here on the punt. And the Packer drive will start from deep in their own territory with a first and 10. To throw now. Here's Love. That's taken in by Watson. And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line. A quick first down pickup. Good start after going 3 and out on their opening drive.
And it's a real luxury when you have a guy who can turn a short throw into a solid gain at any moment. Once he caught that ball, he ID'd where the open grass was and got there in a hurry to pick up a new set of downs for his offense.
Here's Jacobs on first and 10. Just 1 yard on the first down carry, so it's 2nd and 9.
No doubt about it. A really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
After 1-7-0 on EA Sports. Back for the second quarter in Green Bay. It's the Packers in possession of the football. From the 31, here's a 2nd down and 9. to pass. Here's Jordan Love. Looking sideline, incomplete.
That was well played, but that was also an example of a corner who understands his coverage, realized he had support behind him, and could be a little more aggressive in the shorter zone, and did exactly that, knocking that pass away.
After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on third and nine. Now Love. A nifty bit of scrambling there. 12 yards, first down.
That's the first time he's called his own number, but he's got to be overjoyed with the results. He wasn't just going to settle for a modest gain. To me, he was determined to come through with a big message to a defense that slept on him in the pocket.
A couple of first downs, has the football positioned at the 43 as they come up first and 10. Love, pass caught, it's Romeo Doubs. Yeah, that's good for a gain of 6, and it'll be second down.
And I think he just wanted to get the ball to one of his playmakers to see if they can make something happen, but he ends up throwing into a crowded area, and after the catch, he isn't able to do much with it.
From just shy of midfield, here's a second and 4. Love looking to throw it. This complete to the tight end, Tucker Kraft. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. His first catch, good for 8 and a first down.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to, pick up a first down.
Here's Love. A throw out wide, going to be incomplete.
So it looks like they still have some fight in them on this series because it seemed like things were headed for the red zone. But if this defense gets 2 more stops, they can keep them out of that area.
Here's second and 10. Jacobs going to try the middle. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a 3rd and 8 coming up.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
The line to gain is the 33 on third down. Throwing, Love. No, bottled up. It's out, it's loose. And he gets this only to the 41, not near enough for the first. Offensively lucky there, able to keep the football, but now 4th down, so they'll have to boot it away.
I do think, though, they're going to look at this as a positive. 1, they recovered the fumble, so they retained possession. But 2, being able to punt it changes field position for them. Imagine if that turnover takes place there. Now your defense has to go onto the field and try and hold. Instead, they get a little breathing room.
Here's Daniel Whelan now. And this will depend on the spot as it sails out of bounds. And they'll say it sailed out at the 10-yard line. And the Cardinals getting set to trot out there now. The crowd may be losing just a little bit of the edge after back-to-back punts.
They want some big plays. They want to see some offense. They want to see somebody break away, whether it's through the air or on the ground. Now it'll be interesting to see where the patience is on both sides. Each head coach, can you hang in there and not try and force something that could put your team in some jeopardy?
It's Connor as they stay on the ground. And he'll take this ahead for about 4. Second down coming up.
The defense thought they had that play covered, but it still got driven backward by those blockers. Those types of plays are a key part of any team's offensive game plan. It all starts up front in the trenches.
2nd and 6. Play action. Now it's Murray. It's brought in by Wilson. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. 2nd catch for him today, and it'll wind up a 1st down.
The goal for any offense versus his own defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. Open man here is Benson. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down.
So many times in my career, I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing, but as long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
To throw, it's Murray. Able to get this one to McBride. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first.
Well, that was a fun one to watch right there. A nice in-breaking route and plenty of room in the middle of the field. And he was able to get behind the linebackers and grab the completion for a really good pickup.
On first and 10 is Connor. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. A 14-yard pickup. That's 14 yards on two straight plays.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember, the last drive, they went three and out.
Murray now. And he's going to go down. They sack him back right around the 30. Rashawn Gary that time fighting free and getting to the quarterback. So, Charles, no turnovers yet for this offense, but those sacks now, they're starting to pile up.
And one thing usually leads to another because they've got to figure out how the offensive line and everyone else involved in protection can keep their quarterback upright and allow him a chance to throw the ball downfield.
Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. Murray a give. This is Connor. He'll get about six there as he takes this one down to the 24-yard line.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
Here comes the eighth play of the drive, and they need a full 10 yards on third down. Out of the gun, here's Murray. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a first down.
No surprise to see a sideline fired up by that big play. Heck, we're fired up and we're supposed to be neutral. That's a quarterback putting his body on the line to fight and just barely get the first down. When he does something like that, it gets everyone ready to lay it all out there and try and match his intensity.
Murray gonna throw. Screen pass to Connor. Yeah, he'll work free from one tackle, but that's about all as he's taken down. A good convergence there defensively, only a yard, and it's second down.
Good reactions there defensively. That screen was a little slow in developing, and they shut that one down with little gain.
They work now on second and 9. Throwing now is Murray. And he's got it. Got his man on the end route. Complete. And the Cardinals are looking at first and goal as he's tackled all the way down at the 2-yard line.
Boy, this is a well-orchestrated drive they've put together. You think back to how far they were backed up to start things out, but they've gone on a march since then, and now after that completion there, they've got a first and goal.
Now Murray. Bynes, and he is going to go down. Back at the 11-yard line. The Cardinals going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go before halftime. So they get pushed back to the 11, and here's second and goal. To throw is Murray. That's to the left side, taken in by Harrison. Now the Cards going to call another timeout, their second. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Big play coming here. It's third and goal. Here's Murray. Feeling the pressure here and taken down. A sack back at the 7. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 25 seconds to go here in half number one. Fourth down, Murray off, and the Cards field goal unit and Matt Prater out there now. From the left hash, a chip shot here. Prater's kick is good, and that will extend their lead even further.
Well, I don't know if they would have gone for it on fourth and goal anyway, but the sack on third down pretty much made their mind up for them.
You're exactly right about that, and this is a tough place on the field to take a sack because, as you just noted, it took the decision-making away from them. Now they have to go for a field goal instead of potentially going for it.
Prater now will send it away following the made field goal. Oh, a good return up past the 30. And not much doing on the return. Good coverage there. Going to stop him in his tracks at the 15-yard line. The Packer offense heading back for one final first half drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Good starting field position for them as they come up first and 10 at their 35-yard line. Throwing to start the drive. Love. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Jacobs. Now the Packers going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this first half. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Off the play fake, Love. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. This game not quite as good as the last, but still over 40 yards between the two.
And this offense has been a little slow to get going, but some signs of life here in this second quarter. They're moving it pretty good. And that helps the cause as well. Good yardage and another first down.
Back to throw now on first down. And they're going to get him. He's sacked back around the 28. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. Spotted at the left hash, this from 45. And this one is right down the middle. And that will do it for this first half. So we have reached halftime with a touchdown. That's the difference on the scoreboard. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach! All right, Coach, thanks. Yeah, both teams likely to make some changes in what's been a closely fought battle to this point. The Packers set to get the football first, and they are trailing on the scoreboard as we resume action, ready for the third quarter. And he'll be stopped up at the 25. Green Bay's offense ready to go again, and they have had their problems moving the ball through the air as we take you through some of the action from earlier. This secondary has played about as well as you can. Many times they've left this quarterback with nowhere to go with the football.
About set to get this drive started, the Green Bay offense at the line. Now, they're still very much in this game, although they do trail. What's the game plan, Charles, for the second half?
It might be a little counterintuitive because most people will think losing equals passing the ball more, but I'd establish the running game. They kind of went away from it in the first half. I think if they get back in balance, it'll help them when they put the ball back in the air. Oh, that was a nice job there. Quarterback and receiver reading the pressure that was brought. They both knew it was going to open up the middle of the field. Nice little shake and bake in the line of scrimmage, got right into his route, and the quarterback hit him in stride, and he was able to run free after the catch.
So into Cardinal territory now. It's first and 10 at the 49-yard line. Throw left side complete. That's Reed. And a 6-yard gain gets him right around the 43. Line of scrimmage, the 43 on second and 4. Back to throw. Love. Short throw. He's got Kraft. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
That was a route run not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to 1.
His throw incomplete.
At this point in the game and the situation they're in, partner, these incompletions that we're seeing, they need to turn into positive snaps, and soon.
Now a 2nd and 10. Running straight ahead is Jacobs, and tough sledding. He'll get maybe a yard, stop short of the 35.
I have to think a major focus of the halftime meetings had to be figuring out how to create space for the running game to get operating.
Well, what you pointed out to me at half seems accurate. That line has struggled to sustain blocks.
Yeah, I would agree with that totally. They've got to focus on staying on their double teams at the first level, make sure that block's secured before they slide off and try and chip someone at the second level.
And he'll take this beyond the line of scrimmage as he slides to a hole. The decision to tuck and run gets him 3, but that's not enough. Now it's 4th.
Like any team playing, they're looking for touchdowns to try and help their cause. But in this case, he does get them a little closer, at least, if they think a field goal turns out to be the better call here.
4th down and no hesitation from Matt LaFleur as he sends out the field goal unit. They'll put it down right at the 40, so call this a 50-yard attempt. And his kick here is good, and that'll bring him back within 4. So they were facing the deficit coming out of the locker room at intermission, and at least they're able to get the field goal to cut into that deficit.
Yeah, now your offense feels pretty good about itself, right? A little bit more up to speed coming out of the break. You turn to your defense now and say, hey, we got 3 there. We're chipping into the lead. Can you help us out? Hold them. Let's get the ball back for us.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. The Cardinals offense now ready to get their first opportunity here in the second half. Now this game, it has obviously been all about the defense on both sides of the football. Which offense is going to break through here? We'll see if they can do it on this drive. Murray and the Cardinals with a 1st and 10 at their own 22. They'll start the drive with a give to Connor. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Officially no gain on the play, and it's 2nd down.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
2nd and 10. Here's Murray. That pass completed to Dortch. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. So the completion good for just 3. And now 3rd down and 6 to go. They are in need of 6 yards here if they hope to move the chains. Here's Murray as he sets to throw it. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he'll be stopped at the 27-yard line, well short of the first down marker. They'll get only a yard out of that, and it'll bring up fourth down.
The key to any screen play is all in the deception. That means everyone on the offensive side of the ball, but someone gave it up because that one wasn't very well concealed. And the defense able to rally to it and hold him for just a short gain.
And a fair catch signaled for and taken just outside the 20-yard line. So a change of possession here on the punt. And it'll be Packer football here. First down and 10. Love, they go play action now. That's taken in, Dontavian Ricks. And they work this well upfield across the 45. 25 yards that time.
Certainly no settling into the drive there. They came right out on the first play and attacked the middle of the field for a big gainer and a first down.
So one play, and they're already just shy of midfield. On the handoff, this is Jacobs. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple, and that's it.
I'd say they've got to find a way to get him going. He's such a big part of their offense. I wonder if they might throw it a little and come back to the run.
Anything, because you're right. He's pretty much been completely neutralized.
Ball right on the 50-yard line. Here's the second and 8.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down.
It's Zaven Collins who got in there to get the sack.
So one quick, easy analysis about why they've struggled so far. They keep putting themselves in third and long situations. They just took another sack right there.
And the offensive film session tomorrow may be a little longer than it normally is.
Not a lot of positive grades will be handed out thus far.
Here is third and quite a ways. Love now. Looking deep here for Dobbs. This is caught inside the 15. And he's going to get this deep onto Arizona's side of the field. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
That's the kind of play this offense desperately needed. They've got to be saying, our defense has kept us in the ball game. We're down, but we're certainly not out. And maybe that was the spark that they've been searching for.
Here's Jacobs. And he's brought down right at the 5-yard line. Give him 2 on the play.
The yards may start getting a little tougher to come by down here near the goal line. That's good work defensively there on first down, holding them to a short gain.
And the ball smack dab on the 5-yard line. Here's second and goal. To throw now. Here's Love. And he's got it. It's caught for a Packers touchdown. A 5-yard touchdown. And the Packers have taken the lead here in this third quarter.
I wonder if he changed anything on his play sheet or they just executed better. Because they had 2 previous drives that ended in field goals. Before this one, they finally were able to put into the end zone.
Well, whatever he did, speaking of the offensive coordinator, might be using that formula going forward. It worked there.
Yeah, it worked very well. He and his field general in pretty good sync right now. They're starting to move the ball well.
No going for 2. They'll kick the point after. And this one's right there, and that pushes the lead to 13-10. A drive that time of 6 plays, and it ends with a Packers touchdown. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And able to get this out to the 25. Here's the Arizona offense now as they get set to take over. And Charles, a very uninspired effort. The last time we saw them out there was a quick three and out, and they punted the football.
Yeah, and you never want to get stopped so soundly during a series, but what would be even worse now? Is letting it happen again right here. They've got to get going.
Murray and the Cardinals with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. They start the drive with Connor, and he'll manage to pick up about 4. It's second down.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown, so a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later, and let's face it, you could do worse than a 4-yard run on first down.
Murray now to throw. A nifty bit of scrambling there. 12 yards, first down.
Fast, slow, it doesn't matter. If you give a quarterback enough room to escape, he can hit you for a big gain. You've got to give him a little more focus moving forward.
Connor up the middle. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
With his size, he's a tough man to bring down, but they do a nice job there stopping his progress and not allowing him to get back to the line of scrimmage.
Looking at a second and 11 now after the loss. They stay on the ground. Here's Connor again. And he is going to lose yardage here. That'll wind up as a loss on the play. So now they're staring at a third down and 12. We have played 3 quarters. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now at Lambeau. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point. Just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter. From the gun on third down, Murray. Going for the deep ball. And it's knocked away and incomplete. To give you an idea of how accurate he's been throwing the football, we're in the second half. That's just his second incompletion.
Well, if he's that locked in, that means everyone's locked in, because to me it's like throwing a no-hitter in baseball. The pitcher may get the credit, but a lot of people making plays behind him in the field.
Averaging over 50 yards a punt so far as this one's away. This will be fielded at the 17. We'll call it a 42-yard punt, 3 on the return. And out will come the offense as they take over. The Packers offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. Their defense got the stop, forced the punt, and now you really start to monitor the clock as they nurse this slim lead. Love going to break the huddle, lead the Packers up here first and 10 at their own 21. And quickly out wide, this is Watson. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. It'll be a gain of 10 to start the drive out, and by a few inches, that'll be a first down.
Well, how about this aggressive approach? Got the lead, fourth quarter, continuing to throw the football. Are you thinking about Super Bowl 51? Atlanta had the lead against New England, and they ended up giving it up?
I was going to say, don't say it, but you did say it.
I did, didn't I?
Yeah, anybody watching Atlanta, our apologies. They'll go over the middle to Reed, complete. And he'll have it past midfield, almost to the 40, before being taken down. 28 yards the gain there on the catch and run.
And these guys certainly are not hiding what their intention is. They're absolutely showing it. They're definitely not going to sit on this lead here in the fourth quarter.
So in the Cardinal territory now, it's first and 10 at the 42-yard line. Now Love. Over the middle here, it's hauled in by Watson. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling.
These guys are running offense like you drive. The pedal is down, stomp down. How about that? Back-to-back completions, they are rolling.
So much for being conservative and running that football. To the air again, Love. To the left side, there's the tight end Musgrave. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. That's good. The completion there for 7 yards, and it'll be second down. So a decent gain there, but not their fourth consecutive first down like they had on the first three plays.
You sound almost disappointed there. You want to fire the offensive coordinator on that one or what?
They'd gotten into a rhythm. I thought they were just going to keep going.
Well, almost a win for the defense, but if that's your win, you're not doing very well right now.
That'll be enough to keep the drive moving forward. Another first down on the pickup of 5 yards.
Well, that should be a reminder defensively, and I think it's a reminder to myself because you just can't sell out to stop the run. There's still enough time that this offense can move the football through the air, even on first and second downs, and they obviously picked the right spot to throw the ball there.
Over the middle, complete. That's Reed. They'll wind up getting 7 on the play, and that's going to bring up second down. They will throw again here with Jordan Love. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, Packers. Tucker Kraft, a 5-yard touchdown. And the Packers are able to build on to their fourth quarter lead. Well, that's certainly going to bump up the old win probability index because now it's a 2-score game here in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, you're taking me into that deep water now. Win probability index. This game's definitely not over. We're not looking at a half percent or something. It's just 2 scores. But the way that this team has played, to me, what I've seen, they absolutely deserve to win this game. They've been the better team by far throughout.
Extra point right down the middle. And his guys will take a 10-point lead. So that winds up a 7-play drive all told. And the result, a Green Bay score. So the Packer kickoff team set to go as they will kick this one away. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And the script really is flipped for them. The momentum on the other sideline, and now they have to try and battle back from a 2-score deficit. Murray and the Cardinals with a first and 10 right at the 30. They'll try and start this drive in the air. A short one here caught by McBride. So 8 yards on the completion there, and that'll bring up a second down and just a couple.
This possession means so much for them. They've got to focus on this drive and find a way to make this a one possession game. Yes. Got to get a score.
Yeah, so good with a field goal. Don't necessarily need a touchdown.
From the 38 now, here's 2nd and 2.
To throw, it's Murray. Flush to his right. And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down.
Well, collectively as a defense, Charles, I think if you get 4 sacks a game, you're feeling really good. Now they have 6 as a unit.
And that type of a number, it's just staggering because there's so many ways to try and counteract it. But in this case, they've got no answers for this unrelenting pressure coming at their quarterback.
They'll try and run for it with Connor. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42. They're able to convert with a gain of 4. Now, yes, a two-possession game, but a good chunk of time on the clock, so they have the ability still there to run it on second and short, but maybe they need to pick it up a bit.
You're right. They did pick up the first down there, but they, as you mentioned, they have to pick up the pace now because it's a two-possession game. They've got to get there twice to make sure they have a chance to win.
Catch made right side by Wilson. And just 3 yards on the catch there. He couldn't get away. And it's second down. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They're tackling them almost on the spot. That means they have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
From the gun, Murray. Over the middle, Harrison. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. That'll be a pickup of 10 as they try to recover from this 10-point deficit.
But correct me if I'm wrong, yeah, you're down 2 scores. I don't think you need to rush just yet, but you can't take your time either.
Yeah, even if you don't want to commit to full 2-minute offense, you have to up the tempo, up the urgency. Maybe you're starting to call 2 plays in a huddle each time you snap the ball.
He's got his tight end McBride on the out route. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. That one good for 20 on the catch and run.
Well, every drive from here out is definitely crucial and critical. They know that they need to get at least 3 here to get it back to a 1-score game. But I can't imagine that in their huddle that they're thinking at all about getting a field goal. They want to get into the end zone and then try and get the ball back again.
Got his man. It's Dortch. And out of bounds right around the 20. Now 2nd and 5. Now Murray again. And his throw here is incomplete.
And you see passes knocked down by those guys I call the frustrated fullbacks, the linebackers. You know that in their zone coverage, they were able to drop, see the ball thrown, and react to it very quickly.
This offense so far on 3rd down, 3 for 7 so far in this game. This will be 3rd and 5. They run behind center with Connor, and he is going to lose yardage here. 4th down now after a loss of 2. Well, look at the clock. You're down 2 scores. Have to go for this, don't you?
And they thought that as soon as they took over possession. It didn't matter where they were on the field. They were always going to be in 4-down territory. Backed up in good situation, it didn't matter. So they've been preparing for that on their play sheet the entire time.
That's to his running back, complete. And unable to break away, they stop him a few yards shy. The Cardinals unable to convert there on 4th down. And this 10-play drive winds up yielding nothing. So now with a 2-minute warning coming up fast, that puts a mammoth dent in their comeback hopes.
I like how you phrased it. It's a dent because there's still opportunity. They've got to get the ball back on defense, obviously twice. But guess what? This thing is not close to being over. They need to go ahead and play it out.
Not over. As you said, 2-score game still.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And they'll be looking to build off of a nice drive last time, a drive that really relied on the quarterback.
Making good decisions, distributing the ball well, distributing it accurately, keeping it away from danger. A really nicely run drive.
But now the defense, what adjustments do they need to make in the passing game?
Pass rush, pass rush, pass rush. Whether it's the guys up front or maybe you bring additional guys, but you've got to disrupt the timing of them throwing the football.
We'll see if they can disrupt it here.
2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports.
Line of scrimmage, the 28 now as they come up on 2nd and a couple.
He's going to get it again. Just looking to get forward and protect the ball.
And now right out of the two-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with a minute 56 to go. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Once again, it's Jacobs looking for a cutback lane, but nothing there as he's met at the line of scrimmage. Now we're going to get a stoppage here as we've got an injured Cardinal on the field. So as the medical staff takes a look, we'll step aside. Another running situation on the doorstep as they come up second and 10. Here's Jacobs from the gun. And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. Third down and 13. They will run out of the gun with Jacobs. And not much of an opening there as he's only going to get this to about the 32. Just a yard on the run there, and that's going to bring us to a fourth down.
He continues to struggle to find a crease to break off a big one and might need to just put that aside and just try and ram his way forward and get what he can.
On now is the Packers punter as he's on here to punt it away. Fielded just inside the 30. It'll be 37 yards there on the punt.
And they will take over first and 10.
Kyler Murray now in the Cardinal offense. Down 20 to 10. 65 seconds remaining. It's been a struggle to score all day, and now they need to do it twice here late to have a chance. Now Murray. Throwing right, and that's complete. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49.
And that play came together really well for them as he found open space, makes the catch, and gets down to the 1 yard line. You know he's kicking himself right now. He thought he had a chance to get a touchdown and put that in his ledger. Instead, his team gets a chance to cash in over these next few plays.
Oh, he was hit as he threw it there, and that one winds up incomplete.
Tell you what, partner, after he ices down, he's going to be a nice long soak in a hot tub after this one. He's been under duress the entire game.
Yeah, once again, hit as he throws. Fortunate that one wound up incomplete.
Another try, second and 10 now.
Back to throw, Murray.
Back-to-back incompletions, but we know this is definitely four down territory. Time not on their side. I don't think they want to try and get the first down in two installments. I think they got to go and get it right here, right now.
The Lambeau faithful making as much noise as they can. It's third down.
To throw is Murray.
That is incomplete.
That means it's just one last chance left, and this has to be a first down or a touchdown, or this game's over.
The decision made for them. They've got to go. It's fourth down.
Now Murray's got to have this one. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining, and the Packers are going to get the football back in excellent field position. So with that, we can just about close the book on this one, Charles.
Yeah, what's the old expression about slim and none? Well, Slim just left town on that
They're
one.
They're down to none?
Yes, exactly right.
Down to a knee goes Love, and that should be the final act of this football game.
Well, that second half, Charles, a little bit different from the first. Not only did we have the lead change after intermission, but they were able to pitch the shutout in the second half and get an impressive victory.
And what's the old expression? That's not quite how I saw it playing out in my head. You know they didn't expect this at all. As you mentioned, went into the half with the lead. Losing the game is one thing. Getting shut out in the second half, that's a surprise.
So that'll just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to easports.com. The Packers are winners here as we say so long from Lambeau.